What's up, my YT homies? This is Salifia coming in at you with another video. And in this video, I am going to talk about my micro locks. Well, let me say this. My sister locks to micro locks, back to sister locks journey. So as I said, I am going to talk about my sister locks to micro locks to sister locks journey. I did a Get Ready With Me where I was telling you all about me starting my lock journey, or me making plans to start my lock journey. And I told you all that I was going with sister locks. I'm sorry, that I was going with micro locks, because a part of me wanted to save the money on the sister locks, even though I have the money. But a part of me wanted to save the money on getting the sister locks done. And yeah, a part of me just felt like if I go the micro lock way, I could do it myself and all that kind of stuff. Well, that has since changed, and I'm going to tell you why it's changed. Right now, I have my hair in some micro twists, which were supposed to be micro locks. They were supposed to transition into micro locks, and let me tell y'all how many I have. I have a total of 241 twists in my hair. Across this top part around here, there are 95, and then when I did my hair, I separated the bottom part, and that bottom part has 46, and then this quadrant right here over here has 49, and this one has 51, which makes a total of 241 micro twists, which were supposed to be micro twist to locks, tongue twister. So what's up? I am back, and today is Wednesday, and I did not get to do anything to my hair on yesterday. I was tired. I didn't get to do anything, but I do have to get it finished because prom is Saturday, so I have to definitely get it finished before Saturday. So this whole top section right here that I parted off and showed y'all, it is complete, and I have 95 twists that will eventually become locks up there. So what I've done now is I have taken this bottom section of my hair and I parted it off, and I have this section up. So I'm going to do this section, and depending on the timing of it, I'm going to, you know, go into the next section. So what I am going to do is split this section in half down the middle. Now, in a perfect world, I would have somebody else, not even a perfect world, but, you know, I would have somebody doing this for me that could see the parts, or that could part it for me, but I'm going to be using an extra mirror to try to get it parted correctly. So I'm not going to make too much of a fuss about having perfect parts in the back. I did want, you know, perfect parts here in the front and on the side. Okay. I did want perfect parts up in the front and in the back, but the front and on the sides, but I'm not so much as worried about perfect parts in the back. So I do have this hand mirror in front of me. I have a mirror behind me. So I am just going to go ahead and twist this section. Now, this part right here took me 2 hours to do, which was not long. So this took me 2 hours. So I don't know how long it's going to take me to do the rest of it, but I will let you all know. Yeah, so it's about an hour and a half, possibly hour 45 minutes later, and I am completely done with this back bottom portion. Now, with that part, I ended up with 46 twists, which are to become 46 locks, of course. So I'm just going to put this on here to hold this hair out of the way. And then now, since I still have a lot of time, in my opinion, I am going to go ahead and continue on. So what I'm going to do at this point, I'm going to take this part right here. And I said I wasn't going to worry about the parts in the back, but
that turned out to be a lie. I worried about the parts more than I thought. I will tell y'all though that some of them in the back are, I mean, I'm sure the same way up here, but some of them are smaller than others, and that right there, I can't really worry myself about that. So that did happen. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take, and my hair, of course, in the front, as you can see, I'm rocking a side part. I wish I could rock a middle part, but my hair line is so thin, and this side is not as thin as this side, but this side is so thin. So I'm hoping, you know, because I did see my hairline is thin anyway, but I did see some hair, it getting thinner as time went on. And part of it, I do believe, happened because of my weight loss, and some of it I do believe happened because of possibly manipulating my hair, because I, like I said, I have that fine texture hair, and you know, you just can't, you really can't do too much manipulation when you have fine texture hair. You gotta kind of leave it alone, and I did. I kept messing with it, so you know, that's the consequence you pay. So let me get this part, try to get this part straight. Now, here's why I changed from the twist to the locks. Because first of all, I don't want to have to wait forever and a day for my hair to lock up, which I do realize that it's gonna take some time for my hair to mature and lock up with the sister locks. However, I'm having like too much, I guess you could call it, slippage, twist coming to loose. And I would have that before when I would do mini twists. And but I was like, okay, it's not gonna happen, but let me show you what I'm talking about, part of what I'm talking about. So I don't know if you can really see what I'm talking about, but my hair is coming down, it's coming out of the twist. Some of them I've had to retwist, like this was a twist right here, just a little small section. It's no longer a twist. I'm just pulling it up. I had a twist over here. It's no longer a twist. So it's just not even worth it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and make the investment in myself, because guess what? I'm worth it. And the maintenance for sister locks, every 4 to 6 weeks, probably around 125, 130, something like that. That's feasible. That's fine. And anyway, I go in each month. I take, like, I budget at least $100 each month. Probably more than that sometimes, but I budget at least $100 each month just to do whatever, which usually goes towards makeup. Which brings me to the fact that I have a haul. I have a gargantuan haul that I need to do. That's neither here nor there. Now let's go on further. Let me tell you also. So one thing that I did not realize, I did not know sister locks is such a hot commodity. OMG. So I had a consult set up. I thought it was set up for the 26th with this sister lock consultant, but it's actually set up for the 25th. And on the 25th, I have an awards program that I have to go to. So that does not work for me. So when I went to reschedule that appointment with her, her next opening for a consultation is not until May 22nd. That is like a month away. Today is April 18th, so that's a month away. So I went on the sisterlock.com website, found that out from Tanisha Ali, which by the way, I have found so many great lock videos here on YouTube, from sister locks to regular locks to all that. So, and I've just been watching all of them. But anyway, well, all of them that I could find. So anyway, I went on the sisterlock.com website and I found a, to see, you know, in different areas, because sisterlock locticians are registered on there, at least some of them, not all of them, they are registered on there. So I was able to find one that is here in my city as well, because I didn't want to go to like the greater metro Atlanta area, Alpharetta, or anything like that, because it takes 2 to 3 days, depending on your hair, to get the sister locks done. And if I were to go there, I would have to transition every day to go there and then come home, or I would have to get a room and stay there, which would be more money. And I'm not about staying in a hotel overnight for a couple of nights just to get my hair done. So, like I said, I found a lactician here. She's not in a salon. I think she has a salon onto her home. That's what it is. She's a brand ambassador for Sister Locks as well. I've seen some of her work. She's on Facebook. She has pictures. She has videos. All that kind of good jazz. So I've set a consultation up with her for next Friday on the 26th. So what I'm going to have to do is take out some of these locks in the back. That way I can shampoo my hair and keep the integrity of the rest of it, and she can, you know, examine my hair based off of what I have back there and do the test locks. Her next appointment for install is not until June, like June 7th and 8th, but I did let her know that I do have 2 personal days left, because as teachers, we get 3 personal days each year, and I've only taken 1, so I have 2 left. So if I only take those 2 to get my hair done, I can. Now, like I said, I didn't realize sister locks is such a hot commodity, but what I did find out from her is a lot of teachers and principals wait until the summer so they won't have to take days off to get it done. That's number one. A lot of people wait until tax time so they can get it done. A lot of children, people have their children getting it done and stuff like that, which is why it's like so jam-packed and booked up. But I start to kind of travel a little bit on June 13th. So I really want my hair done before I go out and travel into the wilderness, into the world or whatever. So hair locations start at a base price for doing the hair. And like the one that I was going to go to, as I said, her price starts at, she had a certain price that she starts at. And then each inch more is like $75. Well, the lactation that I'm going to, that I've decided on, I'm going to her. She doesn't have a base price. She said what she does is measure each quadrant of the hair, so to speak, each area of the hair, and she averages it, and that is how much she charges. Because she's saying it's not, if you have 6 inches in one part and you have 12 inches on another part, it's not fair to charge you 12 inches for the entire head. Very informative, you know, speaking with her as well as speaking to the other loctician. Both of them were very informative in speaking with me on the phone and all that stuff. I just have to go with what's going to be a bit more convenient for me and my schedule and what I would like to do and how my life runs. So, and also this loctician, the one that I'm going to next Friday, she had more pictures and things and videos, so I could actually see her work, but the other one did not. So it's good to be able to see someone's work and know what you're stepping into, what kind of quality you're stepping into. I do have a plethora of other questions that I'm going to ask her, and I'm quite sure she's not going to mind answering them. So with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and get out of here because I do have to go to work. Thank you all so much for stopping by to catch another one of my videos. If you're new here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you're an oldie but a goodie, thank you so much for continuing to watch and continuing to support me and my channel. Tongue-tied this morning much, huh? So anyway, go ahead, like, comment, subscribe, and share this video across all your social media sites. And until the next time, in the between time, you ladies and gentlemen, be safe, and I will do what? Catch you on the flip side. Bye.